a migratory hummingbird species, and it arrives usually in March, and it departs anytime from July through September. And it times its arrival for when the red flowering currant and the salmonberry bloom, because it's, you know, entirely native plant fed, or at least originally it was, whereas Anna's is sort of a resident hummingbird. It came here from Southern California, is probably its heartland. But it followed the suburbs because of the hummingbird feeders. It sort of worked its way up from Southern California and San Francisco. And one of the reasons it's here is it really likes magnolia. It's full of feeders and full of exotic blooms. And so it's very happy. And it does overwinter.
But anyway, this guy here helped design it with all the plants and everything. Figured out which ones to order.
So did they take out the non-native stuff?
Well, there really wasn't hardly any non-native. Once they took out all the houses and cleared and bulldozed the site, there wasn't very much left.
So it's really
planting
out
for years. But everything is...
Still planting?
Huh?
Are you still planting stuff?
We've got an order in.
Yeah, but we're much more focused now. Uh-huh. We're focused on either on things that we don't have here or things that we found a sort of a micro habitat that needs a certain kind of plant.
I see.
And
nice.
And we need to acquire those, or they're not, the like trillium, for example.
Yeah.
The crabapple, how tall and thin and sort of erect they are. Their leaves are sort of almost like a crown to the tall stem.